In part one of this series, we took a look at how to take a PDF, import it into the queue here, and then export it into an EPUB format. Before we move on to the RTF version of this, let's just take a look at how do you remove things out of this queue once they're in there. And even before we do that, let's take a look over here on the left-hand side at the different options of how things are sorted or categorized. You can certainly type in the name or title of something that you want to look up over here on the side, or you can look into the different categories. For instance, I have three different formats, it says, and if I break this down, I have four EPUBs, two PDFs, and one RTF stored in here. I can also take a look at how many different publishers I have. In this case, there's two. Calibre and Digital Publishing House, or Digipub, are the ones in there, and tags. I can look through all the different sorting options. But even once I want to get rid of something out of my queue up here, I certainly can come up and select something, highlight it in yellow, and for instance, in this case, it's an RTF and an EPUB. It's a really ugly document. In fact, I could show it to you, but I don't even think it's worth showing to you because this was that RTF document with images in it, and it wouldn't even take those images and transform them into EPUB, so it wasn't even worth keeping. In that case, I want to delete this thing. If I right-click on this, I have the option to remove the book. And so I'm going to remove the selected book. And it's going to say, are you sure you want to delete this permanently? And in this case, yes, I do. So now I only have two books left. This time, though, let's take a look at how to jump into something like this, which is a Word document, no images at all. And before we jump into RTF, let's backpedal about five spaces here and take a look at how do I save this or create a PDF out of my Word document? Because as you recall, you can't take a Word document and put it into Calibre. You need it in RTF or PDF are the two simplest versions to bring it in as. If I come up here and go File, Save As. Remember, this is on a Mac now, so this might be a little bit different from computer to computer, but the same basic principles apply. This is within Microsoft Word. You could do this in OpenOffice or Pages or almost any word processing format. Once I jump in here, typically you have a place where you can choose from your different file formats that you want to save it as. And if I jump down here, Mac comes standard with the PDF option. And if you have Adobe Acrobat or some other PDF extension put into Microsoft Word, you should be able to save it as a PDF. If you don't have that option, you should notice you do have the option to save it as a rich text format or RTF. I'm going to pick that, and here I can save this rich text format of this document. Let's just save it to my desktop, and I'll hit save, and there, it saved it as a RTF. Some of the other options are, even if you cannot save something as a PDF, sometimes you can do things in a sneaky manner and print them as a PDF. You can install, regardless of what computer you have, you can install a printer PDF driver. If you just go out to Google and type in PDF printer driver, and you can probably find tutorials all over the websites or all over Google, YouTube on how to take and install a PDF printer, and you can take care of this next step through that PDF printer. Because when I choose print on my computer, I'm given the option to save it as a PDF. And if you're on a PC, you'd probably be able to use this pull down and pick from your PDF printer, which won't spit anything out at all physically, but it will create a PDF for you. I know that sounds a little bit confusing, but if you're looking to create a PDF with your Word document, just Google it. Google Word to PDF or PDF print driver. One of those two will take care of you. I'm going to jump out of here and just show you quickly. I've converted this to RTF. It's no longer a .doc, so I can come back to Calibri and I can ingest that file. There we go. I can ingest that file through the Add Books. I can go to Add Books from a single directory, and I can find that book on my desktop where I put it. Here I am, week four, steps to completion, EDU 654, RTF file. Double-click that. And it should add it just like it did with the PDF. It should only take a few seconds. There it is. And now I can take that, and just like before, it says RTF, but I can convert that document in one fell click. Click on this and change that look and feel if I so desire. page setups. Remember, the metadata was up here. And if I scroll down a little bit, I can change the cover page and grab an image if I'd like. I can change the structuring, table of contents. In this case, it's a very short document. Really, all of this is a moot point. So I'm just going to hit OK. Wait for a little bit as this thing queues up, and there's my wheel spinning again. Down here it's going to say job one. Rotate for a little bit, and then all of a sudden EPUB's, there it is. EPUB pops up, and I should be able to open that up. You can see, although it's ugly, and it even threw in this little title up here for me as a generic cover page for me, you can see that it did take all of my content, although, like I said, not the prettiest thing in the world. It successfully brought all of my content into this and created an EPUB document out of it, which allows me to change font size extremely easily. And I can certainly take this and put this on almost any e-reader in the world, including an iPad in the iBook store or wherever I want to go with this document. Now, the next step is, how do I take this document and open it on my iPad, or how do I share it with others? Because you've seen how to take and convert them, but how do we share it? That's the next portion of the video. The first way to share this document is save it to your hard drive. And we'll get to the connect and share here in a second, but if you want to save it via the old standard means of emailing it to somebody, saving it to a disk is about as easy as it gets. You click on Save to Disk, make sure that you have the document highlighted that you intend to save. You click on the button. It's just going to ask you, where do you want to save this document? You click Choose once you're done, or Select, depending on what program or what operating system you're on. And it's going to collect the manifest data, and it plopped it into my desktop here. Well, where is it? Don't be deceived, because not only did it create the EPUB file there, it created a brand new folder for you. And as I scroll down here, you're going to see it names the folder according to the author. So if you were listed as the author, it's going to name a folder with your name in it. If the name of the author is Big Books, it's going to create a folder called Big Books. And inside that author folder, you're going to find all of the books that you've exported. So if I go up and I choose another book to export or to save to my desktop, it'll create a brand new folder inside of here. For me, it lists it as week 4, steps to completion. That's what I've created. And this may seem baffling, but it has 3 separate documents inside of it, even though I said save to disk on just that one piece. Because if you remember correctly, that RTF is what it used to create it. Then the OPF is really manifest information. It's almost insignificant altogether, just has 1 kilobyte of information. Then the actual EPUB will end in .epub, EPUB. And this is the actual EPUB document. If I want to share this with somebody, I attach it just like I would a Word document or a PowerPoint to an email. So I'm going to send this document to myself and then open it on my iPad so you can see what it looks like. Attaching the file. I'm going to locate that folder with my author name on there. Double click on it. Go into the folder that contains all of my documents. There's the EPUB file, EPUB. Double click it and it attaches it, and I'm going to send it off. Here's the iPad, and this is the email that I just received from myself, EPUB document. Hopefully you can see this, and as I scroll down, there it is right there. And if I just hold on to that, it says open how. I'm going to pick in iBooks. Should jump me over to my iBooks bookshelf, and it's going to take a few seconds for that to populate here. But there we go. It opened up all by itself. Remember, it's got that generic title page in there that are automatically put in there for me, and I can page through this thing. There's my steps to completion. Actually, it looks a little bit better on the iPad than it did on that e-reader on my computer. And I took that RTF document and I made an EPUB document out of it, and it will always be sitting here in my library, right there. Pretty simple. That's the basics of taking an RTF, or even a PDF in this case. This one was PDF, and putting it into your iTunes account or into your iBooks account on your bookshelf, or sharing it with other people in that way. Let's take a quick look at how to share it on iTunes, and then we'll be done. Once you're ready to share it with your iTunes account, you certainly need to realize that you have to have an actual iTunes account. But once you have iTunes on your computer and you're ready to go, and you can even set up your iPad to work with this as well if you want to connect another device so you can send it directly to your iPad or iPhone, and there are even some other devices that you can send this directly to, but you need to set that up through some of your settings. I'll show you the easy way of doing this, however. You hit the connect and share, and you connect to iTunes. You can do an offsite folder as well, where you connect it to this, to a cloud folder. But once you do this, all of a sudden you get two brand new buttons, send to device and send to iTunes, or you can set up your device right here. So I can take this document and I can click on this. It says show books in main memory of device, or I can eject this device, but it's already connected to iTunes in the background. By the way, this may take a little bit if you don't have iTunes in the background, because hitting this connect button will force iTunes to open first and then it will connect. I had it open already, so it connected quickly. Once I have iTunes set up, I can just hit send to device. That means it's going to send it to my computer to the iTunes folder or the iTunes gallery. So I'm going to hit send to device. It takes a few seconds and it's already done sending. If I go visit my iTunes now, which is over here, there we go, and I open this up, there it is. Week 4, steps completion, double click it, and it should open up as a book in my iTunes, which is really nice. And actually, the next time I sync my iPad up with my Mac or with iTunes, and in fact if I have the cloud sync already set up, it's going to automatically sync with my iPad. I don't need to do anything else. That book will automatically sync up. But if I want to check it out on here, I can even take it and I can read it from my computer as well. Those are the easiest ways to share your information, to share your EPUB when you're all done. Like I said, the one that makes the most sense to a lot of people might just be to email that EPUB off. That's the end of how you take a PDF or an RTF and you EPUB it and then you share it.